Hvala lijepo našem zboru, a ujedno bi...
I thank our choir, and I would like to introduce our first lecturer, Hubert Lieberer.
Njemački veliki poduzetnik koji je rođen 1900...
A great German entrepreneur born in Munich, in Bavaria. He finished construction degree, and he had a firm that employed over 30,000 employees, making industrial machinery of various kinds. From 1988, after coming to Međugorje, he has followed the Lord's call. Leave everything you have and come follow me. With friends, he has established an association, Međugorje Deutschland, in order to be able to make Germany aware of Međugorje. And especially, he is involved with the building of churches in Russia. Welcome, Herbert. Please take the microphone. Praise be Jesus and Mary. I'm pleased that here in Međugorje I can speak about something that I never thought I would do in my life. Had someone 20 years ago told me that I would witness before so many people, I would say never. In 1997, I was with one of the princes in Fatima.
Und so sind wir mit dem Privatflugzeug Wall fliegen gegangen. Wie sagt man?
Ja, sam sam pilot znam, dakle voziti avione.
I myself am a pilot. I know how to fly a plane, so the two of us went on a flight pilgrimage.
Denn ich komme aus dieser Familie. Diese Firma, die mein Vater nach dem Krieg gegründet hat, die heute eben 30.000 Mitarbeiter beschäftigt und zu 100% in Familienbesitz ist.
I remember a family that has an enterprise that my father has established after the war, who today has 30,000 employees.
Dass ich mit meinem eigenen Flugzeug auf Wallfahrten gegangen bin.
And even now the firm is in private ownership, as it was completely understandable that I would go on a pilgrimage in a private plane. On our way back, the friend asked me if I knew of Međugorje. I said, no, I don't know what Međugorje is. I've never heard such a strange word. Unusual. And it told me that it was a village in Yugoslavia where a lady has been appearing daily to four young people.
Hatte ich eine Sehnsucht nach Međugorje in meinem Herzen.
And from that moment in my heart, I felt a longing for Međugorje. The opportunity came to come to Međugorje for the anniversary in 1987. Again, we came with a private plane. We landed in Mostar.
prvi posjet Međugorje za mene je bio više razočarenje nego bilo što drugo.
And for me, that first visit to Međugorje was a disappointment more than anything else. In any event, at the very beginning.
Ich aus Deutschland, als junger Unternehmer, mit dem eigenen Flugzeug, natürlich, so ein kleines, mittleres Wunder, dachte ich, muss der Herr jetzt schon wirken für mich.
I thought, I am coming, me, a young entrepreneur from Germany with my own plane. The Lord would need to work at least some medium miracle for me.
Es waren so viele Menschen da und ich war auch auf dem Kreuzberg oben und ich habe auch meinen Rosenkranz dann gebetet. Aber ich konnte ihn damals noch nicht so, dass sie das kaputt geht. Das ist nur eine Hälfte. Ich konnte den noch nicht so offen in der Hand tragen wie hier, weil ich dachte, das sind so viele Menschen, die mich kennen, vielleicht aus Deutschland. Und wenn ich zurückkomme, dann lachen mich alle aus, weil ich Rosenkranz gebetet habe.
We came in the afternoon. We were on the Cross Mountain. I had my rosary with me. I took it out of the pocket. Yes, this one, which is already all broken. Then I didn't dare to raise the rosary so visibly because somebody might laugh. I was too renowned. So I hid the rosary in my hand. I came down from the hill, and late in the afternoon, I sat close to the church on a small wall that is no longer here. And I watched how many people were approaching the sacrament of reconciliation of God's love. Those 27 confessionals were not there at the time.
Und hatten ein Schild vor sich stehen, welche Sprachen sie sprechen.
Svećenici su sjedili na stolčićima pored crkve.
The priest sat on little chairs in front of the church, and in front of them there was a sign of the language that they spoke.
Gledam ja tako i odjedno mi pozlije.
And as I was looking, I became dizzy.
Meni inače nikad u životu nije pozlilo. Ja ne znam šta to znači da nekom.
I have never felt faint in my life. I don't even know what it feels like. Not in a car, not in a plane, not in a boat. I've never felt sick. But all at once I felt sick here.
Und jetzt wird es dir schlecht und es soll ein Gnadenort sein.
I was already disappointed. Here I'm already feeling faint and it has to be a place of grace.
Abgereist wäre.
I to je bio trenutak u kojem sam bio istrgnut iz svojeg razočaranja.
And that was the moment when I was broken away from my disappointment.
In einer Kirche, an wo ich Anfang 20 war, in Belgien, und das war nicht gut.
Pardon, krivo sam prevela, hab falsch übersetzt. Toliko sam bio razočaran da sam u tom trenutku bio spreman.
I was so disappointed that at that moment I was prepared to leave. And this reminded me of an experience that happened 20 years before in another church. And right away I said to myself that there is something that I have to confess.
Nämlich, wenn ich zurückkomme nach Deutschland, am nächsten Samstag in einer Stadt weit weg von zu Hause, wo mich niemand kennt.
And so I decided that right away when I return home, I will go to an unknown church, to an unknown town where nobody knows me.
Vor allen Menschen zum Beichten zu gehen. Nein, das konnte ich nicht.
Otići ovdje na ispovjed pred svim tim ljudima.
To go here to confession in front of these people, I couldn't do it.
Ja, der Brechreiz wurde so intensiv, dass ich war drauf und dran, mich übergeben zu müssen.
Dakle, toliko mi je bilo zlo, toliko mi je išlo na povraćaj.
I was so nauseous, I felt like vomiting, that with great trouble. I try to retain myself. And I said to myself, Hubert, get out of here, because a catastrophe is going to happen.
In dem Moment war ich in einem ganzen Gewühl von Menschen wie gefangen und plötzlich steht vor mir ein Priester, er macht den Klappstuhl auf, setzt sich hin und stellt das Schild Deutsch davor.
I kako sam ustao, tako sam se našao.
And as I got up,
gužvi, među ljudima,
I found myself in a crowd among people.
Od tih ljudi koji su me okruživali,
I couldn't go anywhere because of this crowd. And at once, there was a priest in front of me. He puts his chair down with a sign, German. It is difficult to explain what happened inside of me at that time. But it is a fact that I fell to my knees, I cried crocodile tears, and I confessed every evil that I had ever done in my life. I cried as I'd never cried, and I said to myself, I'm so woeful that the Lord will never be able to forgive me everything that I've done.
War alles weg und ich hatte so einen tiefen Frieden in meinem Herzen.
But after a priest had spoken the absolution over me, everything was gone. And I felt a deep peace like never before in my life.
Gott hat dir verziehen und er liebt dich trotzdem.
I to predivno iskustvo, Bog ti je oprostio i ljubi.
The beautiful experience God has forgiven you and he loves you.
Dachten uns, dass wir mehr für Mittelgold tun möchten.
Vratili smo se u Njemačku.
Returned to Germany.
Da bismo željeli učiniti još nešto više za Međugorje.
And we thought they would like to do more for Međugorje. Wir
begannen überall von Marienerscheinungen zu sprechen, Lord Fatima und auch ganz schnell Međugorje.
Moj prijatelj Albrecht i ja počeli smo.
My friend Albrecht and I started to speak about apparitions, about Fatima, and very quickly about Medjugorje.
Unsere Heimatstadt 1988 im Sommer einen Vortrag zu halten über Medjugorje.
I onda u našem gradu gdje živimo.
And in our city where we live, in the summer of 88, they asked us to go speak about Medjugorje.
Begeistert davon.
Stvarno nije bio oduševljen.
My father really was not enthusiastic about this.
Der Glaube ist etwas Persönliches.
Govorio da je vjera nešto osobno.
He said that faith is something personal.
Dann machst du dich vor den ungläubigen Mitarbeitern lächerlich.
Govorio je, ako se javno.
He used to say, if you publicly come forward with things like this, you will appear silly in front of those who are not believers.
Kannst es dir nicht erlauben, dass du nur von einem Teil der Mitarbeiter anerkannt bist und vom anderen Teil nicht.
And you, as an entrepreneur, cannot afford to have only a few of your employees respect you and others not.
Nicht mal von der Kirche anerkannt und es ist die Sache der Priester und nicht deine und schon gar nicht in der Stadthalle, in dieser Stadt, wo allein dort über 1000 Menschen für unsere Firma arbeiten.
And he said to me that nonetheless Medjugorje was not approved by the church, that it's not a matter of it being my issue, but that of priests, it's not a matter of speaking about it in a city where thousands of the workers were living in.
Rief mich mein Freund an und sagte, es sei eine Krankheit in seiner Familie, er muss verreisen. Ich soll den Vortrag halten.
Dan prije tog događaja,
the day before that event
se dogoditi,
that needed to take place,
da ima, bolest u obitelji,
my friend called me and said that there is a sickness in the family, that he has to leave and that I have to speak.
Auf der anderen Seite aber, das Versprechen, mich mehr für Međugorje einzusetzen.
I to je bila jako teška situacija.
That was a very difficult situation. Because I understood the position of my father. But on the other hand, I wanted to keep the promise that I gave in Međugorje.
Nije se više moglo otkazati, bilo je prekasno.
It could no longer be cancelled, it was too late. And so I had to give that lecture.
I had
a very uncomfortable feeling.
Nach dem Vortrag ging ich ja in eine Kapelle, wo ich den Herrn bat, möge mir zeigen, was für mich der richtige Weg in der Zukunft ist.
Nakon predavanja sam otišao u jednu kapelicu i molio sam Boga da mi pokaže.
After the talk I went to chapel and I prayed to God asking him what the proper way and the right way for me was for my future.
Bevor wir mit der ersten Pilgergruppe nach Međugorje kamen.
Odgovor na to pitanje dobio sam.
I received the answer to that question the day before I left to Međugorje with our first group of pilgrims. In October of
97, um mit dem Priester zu sprechen, der uns begleitet hat.
Before we left with the plane, we went to a place in Međugorje in order to speak with the priest who needed to accompany us.
Jeden Tag eine Pilgermesse gefeiert.
Došli smo i tamo se svaki dan u 3 sata slavi hodočasnička misa.
We came and there every day at 3 o'clock a pilgrim mass is celebrated. We were at that mass.
So möchte ich mal sagen.
I nakon 10 minuta najedanput me obuzeo osjećaj kajanja.
And after 10 minutes a feeling of repentance overcame me.
Osjetio sam koliko sam Boga povrijedio time što ga tolike godine nisam tražio.
I felt that I offended God in that I had not sought him for so many years. And I started to cry in the church that normally does not happen to me.
To je se malo smirilo kad je došlo vrijeme za pričest, tako da sam mogao pristupiti pričesti.
That calmed down a bit so that I was able to receive communion.
Anschluss ein Weihegebet an das unbefleckte Herz Mariens gesprochen.
U toj crkvi nakon hodočasničke mise.
And in that church after the pilgrim mass there is also regularly the consecration to the Immaculate Heart of Mary that is prayed.
Poduži tekst kojeg nisam poznavao.
It was a lengthier text that I was not familiar with.
Tekst je čitala na pultu naprijed jedna gospođa.
A lady was reading the text at the pulpit. I didn't pay much attention, I was overoccupied with myself. And then at once I felt, I didn't hear it, clearly and loudly. Now, your answer is coming. The answer to the question, what I am to do in the future, in what way I am to intercede for
Međugorje.
And at once, my attention became very clear. I looked at this lady and heard and listened to every word that she was reading. And in that prayer of consecration, there was a biblical sentence that all of you know, and which reads, leave everything you have and everything you are, come follow me.
Gerechnet hätte, aber nicht mit so etwas.
Mogu vam reći da sam računao na sve moguće, ali ne.
I can say to you that I counted on everything, but not on this.
Sowas Umfassendes, sowas Überwältigendes. Ich war sprachlos.
To je nešto tako veliko, tako...
That was so immense, so massive, that I was without text.
Was heißt es für mich?
And I started to think about what this means for me.
Was ist meine Arbeit? Wovon lebe ich?
What is my assignment? What is my work? What do I live from? I said, Lord, I'm an engineer, a builder, I'm not a theologian. And 1,000 questions and not a single answer. And I said, God, I cannot do it. I felt that this surpassed me immeasurably. And then I remembered that the next day I was flying to Medjugorje with that first pilgrim group. And then I had the courage to say, Blessed Mother, if you really want this, then give me yet another sign. And I will understand that you really want this.
So sind wir am nächsten Tag losgeflogen.
And so we flew out the next day. We came, we took to our rooms.
Das war ein blödes Gefühl. Ich habe immer geschaut, siehst du ein Zeichen?
Looked around to see if I could see any sign. Sun, cross, across mountain. I looked everywhere because I didn't know what such a sign should look like. Oh, there was nothing. In the evening I went to bed and I was very sad. And I thought, certainly, it's a mistake that I thought that the sign would come on the first day since we are staying for several days. And I said to myself, Hubert, this is all an illusion, you can't live like this, it's finished. And for me, that was all over. And so the next day, with a peaceful heart, I was able to go to the German Mass at 9 o'clock. It was Sunday. And for me, everything was solved. And the opening song was what all of the German-speaking people know. Mary, take me, who am your child. Give me peace in this world. Peace in this world and heaven on the other side. And at the moment, when the word heaven was pronounced, everything changed inside of me. It's very difficult to describe. I could no longer hear the voices that the people were singing with my ears, but with my whole body, as if my whole body was an ear. I had the feeling that all the heavenly choirs were giving glory to God except me, poor sinner, who is among them.
Aber ich habe spüren dürfen.
I didn't see anything, but I was allowed to feel.
And
the only way to describe what I experienced was an unendurable glory. A glory that I could not endure. I want to leave. I lowered my head to the ground. And if there was a hole in the ground, I would have crawled in it.
Meine irdischen Probleme, die ich hatte, in der Sekunde null, die waren nicht mehr existent.
And before the greatness of the glory, all of my human earthly problems simply disappeared. They were no longer there.
So konnte ich im Anschluss daran, ohne auch nur eine Sekunde nachzudenken, mit einer Sicherheit sagen, ja, ich werde alles verlassen, was ich bin und habe, und werde dir nachfolgen.
And after the experience, I could say without any hesitation, completely certain, I will leave everything that I have and am, and I will follow you. Then, now, or in the future, I don't know what this sentence means for me. I returned home. I spoke with my father. I came back home. I told my father everything that happened. And I told him that as of now, I don't want to work for him anymore, but only for heaven. For my father, this was very difficult. Until that moment, both to him and to me, it was clear that I belong to the world of the technology, engineering, industrial machines that even fascinate me to this day, and that together with my brothers I would continue to run this firm. And that is why it was very difficult for my father when I told him that I no longer wanted to work for him. I repeated that several times and affirm that this is my strong desire. And at the very end, a father said, you're an adult, you know what you want, if that is your way, then go.
And in unserer Familie war der Vermögensübergang der ersten Generation meines Vaters auf uns fünf Kinder bereits vollzogen. Das heißt, jeder von uns hat ein Fünftel des gesamten Firmenvermögens geerbt.
In our family, the father had already solved all of the problems of inheritance of us five children. He had divided one fifth of all that he owned among us.
Dass es nicht fair wäre von mir, wenn ich so ein großes Vermögen besitze.
To each of us.
Ja sam imao osjećaj, ne bi bilo fair da posjedujem tako veliku.
I felt that it wouldn't be fair
da ništa ne činim
to possess such great means and to do nothing for them. And I said to my father that I want to give back to him my part of the inheritance.
Sagte er, fragte mich, wovon willst du dann mal leben?
Then my father asked me, then what will you live from?
Und da sagte ich, das weiß ich noch nicht, aber da wird sich schon was finden.
I said to him, I didn't know, but that for sure something would come about.
Es kommt gar nicht in Frage, dass du noch mal vom Betteln leben musst.
And my father said that it's not up for discussion for me to live from some kind of begging. Since my wife and I don't have children, my father decided
hat er verfügt, dass aus diesem ehemaligen meinem Vermögen sie meiner Frau und mir eine regelmäßige Zahlung zukommen lassen müssen bis zu unserem Lebensende, so dass unser finanzieller Unterhalt gesichert ist.
My father decided that those who would take over that one-fifth of my inheritance, that they would oblige themselves to give my wife and myself a monthly income for us to live on. And after that, an inexpressibly difficult time came about. The first 6 months after that decision, I think that was the most difficult that ever happened to me in my life.
Meine Freunde, meine Geschwister, meine Verwandten, keiner konnte mich verstehen, auch meine Frau nicht.
Not my brothers, not my cousins, not friends, not my wife could understand me. Everyone asked me all kinds of questions.
Tut sich daher von Haus aus einfach schwer mit der Mutter Gottes.
Moja žena je protestantkinja.
My wife is a Protestant. And for her it's very difficult to have any kind of relationship. The Blessed Mother barely means anything to her. And everyone tried to pull me away from that way. They told me that belonged to such a firm. How could I leave it? And what will you do?
Wenn du so eine Lebensentscheidung triffst, dann musst du eine klare Perspektive haben.
You're an entrepreneur. If you decide this, then you must have a very clear perspective.
Ich weiß es nicht.
And I said, I don't know.
Das gibt's ja nicht. Jetzt steigt er aus so einer Firma aus und weiß nicht mal, was er will. Jetzt spinnt er total.
And everybody said, he completely went out of his mind. He's leaving this firm and doesn't even know what he's going to be doing. He's gone crazy. My wife had some theological discussions with me. She's very well versed in sacred scripture. She asked me, do you even know where certain parables were in John, Luke? I said, no, I didn't. And then I told her I was trying to be important, I'm deceiving people, then I'm trying to give lectures, then I didn't even know the sacred scripture. Once she literally threw the Bible at my head, and she was for sure that I wasn't normal. Then I had to go to a psychiatrist with her. I had to prove that I was normal. At that time, I really wrestled.
Meine Freunde zu mir zu Besuch, nur mit dem Ziel, mich davon wieder abzubringen.
Und da war
nachts im Bett, wo ich.
And my friends came to me day and night for me to try to change my decision. And at night I would ask myself, my God, what do you want from me? I had a feeling that he gave me a rendezvous and didn't come to meet me.
Ich soll zum Psychiater und überhaupt, ich bin Bauernschnör, ich bin kein Theologe. Warum hast du mich genommen? Warum mich?
Then I asked him, what is it? why did you choose me? They think I'm crazy. They're taking me to a psychiatrist. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not a theologian. I am a building engineer. Why have you chosen me? Why didn't you choose a professor who knows this, who is smart, who is educated, who can give arguments? I can't. And yet,
in so einer Nacht, jetzt hörte ich eine männliche Stimme.
In one such night, I heard a male voice. It came from my heart. I didn't hear it from my ears, but from within.
Wie willst du je deinen Glauben bezeugen, wenn du es nicht mal vor deinen Freunden kannst?
And the voice said to me, how do you think that you are to witness your faith when you can't even do it in front of your friends? I learned much from that. It meant much to me. I understood.
Ich habe sicher damals auch den Fehler gemacht, dass ich versuchte, andere Menschen von meinem Glauben zu überzeugen.
I made a mistake. I tried to convince people of my faith. And this is not what it's about.
Ich muss niemanden von meinem Glauben überzeugen.
It became clear to me that I don't have to convince anyone of my faith.
Mit der Gnade Gottes und damit bezeuge ich meinen Glauben.
I only need to go on my way, believing in God. And by that I will give a witness of my faith. And nothing more is asked of me.
Und ich wünsche, beten Sie für mich, dass ich diesen Weg gehen kann, um damit unseren Glauben zu bezeugen.
That is why I ask you to pray for me, that together we may witness our faith. Thank you. Thank you very much, Hubert, for your life witness. And you are the inspiration, knowing that when a person has God, he has more than what he needs. We will have a break with the music.